Infinix is known for budget phones. They are doing quite well in South Asian markets like Bangladesh and Pakistan with its Smart and Note lineup, and the company is trying to replicate the success with the introduction of its Zero series as well. The Infinix Zero 8 that I have with me shares a lot of similarities with the Zero 8i that was launched in India, with the only difference being in the camera sensors. But with cutthroat competition in the market from brands like Redmi and Realme, can Infinix find any success with these devices? Well, let's find that out in this review. As with most other Infinix phones that we've seen in the past, the company has gone big on the design of the Zero 8. Just look at it, it's so radical. But from the back, it features a bold design, and if you're okay with the big phone, it will fare you nicely. Featuring a two-tone geometrical pattern, this gem-cut aesthetics looks pleasing to look at. Moreover, the bottom half of the rear panel also reflects different colors depending on how you look at it. But because of its glossy finish, it does attract smudges, which fortunately is not visible as much in this silver color option that I have. Its big diamond-shaped camera bump also stands out among other devices, but sadly it has a significant level of wobble when placed on a flat surface. As for the build quality, the entire phone is made of plastic, including the frames. It is also a big phone, so people with small hands may find it a challenge to get around with it. Likewise, the weight distribution feels slightly uneven, with the lower half of the phone feeling considerably heavier. Now moving on, the right frame of the phone houses the fingerprint sensor, which doubles as a power button as well. It is well placed and scans your fingerprint pretty quickly too. Just next to it lies the volume rockers. These two are placed well within the reach of my hands, so I did not have a problem here. Okay, getting to the display, this phone boasts a massive 6.85 inches IPS panel with full HD resolution. And to appeal the budget mobile gaming community, the Zero 8 also has a 90Hz refresh rate. Additionally, the screen is also protected by Corning's Gorilla Glass 3. You can see the pill-shaped cutout for the dual cameras on the top left corner of the screen. I would have liked to see Infinix implement a sleeker cutout, but here we are. Anyway, thanks to the smoother 90Hz refresh rate and 180Hz touch sampling rate, from regular usage to gaming, everything feels pretty smooth. However, comparing it against the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max, the inferiority of this panel in terms of contrast, vibrancy, and sharpness becomes crystal clear. Besides, I am slightly let down with the fact that there isn't an option to change the color temperature of this display. Similarly, it only has got Widevine L3 certification, so the actual viewing experience is pretty bland. Jumping to the performance side of things, it is powered by the MediaTek Helio G90T and a single 8GB RAM and 128GB memory option. With this, the performance of the Zero 8 is quite good. In fact, the performance is one of the best things about this phone. As you'd expect, there's not much of a lag on regular usage, including light to medium multitasking. When the 90Hz refresh rate kicks in, scrolling the UI or the web gets pretty smooth, and the UI is pretty optimized and feels fast. You can also switch the screen refresh rate to 60Hz or select the automatic mode, where the system switches between the two levels depending on the content that you're watching on the screen. While the performance aspect of this phone is pretty respectable, the XOS is pretty terrible. The phone comes with a bunch of bloatware apps pre-installed, most of them from the Infinix ecosystem itself. You can disable them, but you cannot uninstall them. And yes, these apps do send loads of ads and notifications. But after uninstalling or disabling the unnecessary bloatware, the app notification and ads is less frequent. When it comes to gaming, the Helio G90T is a good performer. Heavy games like PUBG and Call of Duty can run pretty smoothly. By swiping from the left edge, you can go to the game optimization screen and access various features like blocking incoming calls, taking a screenshot, etc. One neat feature is that it lets you use the phone's volume buttons as extra controls for different games. Likewise, I also tried games like Genshin Impact and PES. Playing those titles under 60fps, I did not notice any frame stutter on the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max, but I did notice a few instances of such on the Infinix Zero 8. The classic MediaTek versus Qualcomm debate comes into play here. Throughout my gaming sessions, I did not find the Helio G90T to be as optimized and cooler as the Snapdragon 720G, although these two silicons are on par when it comes to benchmark scores. The Zero 8 does have liquid cooling technology, but even with this, the phone takes rather long to cool down. But it isn't something of a deal breaker, I guess. Now let's get into the cameras. Infinix Zero 8 comes with a quad camera setup at the back, led by a 64-megapixel Sony IMX686 primary sensor. Alongside this are the 8-megapixel ultra-wide angle, a 2-megapixel depth sensor, and a 2-megapixel macro camera. Similarly, the front of the phone houses a 48-megapixel primary and an 8-megapixel wide-angle camera inside the cutout. And to judge its camera capabilities, I compared it against the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max. As you can see, compared to the Note 9 Pro Max, the primary images from the Infinix 08 look soft with less details, and the colors are quite desaturated too. Similarly, the wide-angle shots too come out soft on the 08. Portrait images are good, but yet again, they look desaturated for some reason. And compared to the Note 9 Pro Max's portraits, the one from the 08 looks inferior, especially during low light conditions. Now moving to the nighttime shots, the images are lacking in detail and exposure management, whereas the Note 9 Pro Max can shoot sharper low light photos with better exposure. Up front, selfies from the 48-megapixel sensor have nice sharpness but are not HDR optimized. And edge detection in portrait selfies is not that good either. The 8-megapixel wide-angle lens though is an added bonus for group selfies. One interesting thing is that you can also turn on the selfie camera by swiping down the camera cutout on the lock screen. Plus, the animation looks pretty cool as well. When it comes to videos, the Infinix 08 can shoot up to 4K 30fps footages, but as expected, it lacks any sort of stabilization. However, you can record slightly stable videos when switching the resolution to 1080p 30fps or 720p at 30fps. Onto the battery front, the company has packed a decent 4,500 mAh cell on the 08. With the 90Hz refresh rate turned on, I managed to net out around 5 to 6 hours of screen on time, which is not exceptional, but good nonetheless. To squeeze out more battery life, you can turn on the power boost feature inside the power marathon menu and get a couple of extra hours of screen on time. Charging up the phone is quick though. It supports 33-watt fast charging, and thankfully Infinix ships the 33-watt fast charger inside the box. With this, it takes about 1 hour and 5 to 10 minutes to get from nil to 100%. The audio setup on the 08 is nothing to write home about either. It has a single bottom firing speaker setup, and the audio is not that great. It sounds flat and there isn't enough richness or details at all to enjoy it. The pre-installed DTS sound app does let you play around with the equalizer or different sound profiles. As a result, the phone's audio quality is somewhat improved by messing around with this app. To sum it all up, the Infinix 08 is the company's first attempt at a gaming-focused mid-range phone. Trying to make a name for oneself in an already crowded industry is no easy job, and Infinix does deserve some credit here for putting out a well-designed and well-performing smartphone. It is a good first attempt, but ultimately the 08 is haunted by the company's inherent flaws in other departments like software and camera. Featuring a 64-megapixel main sensor and a 48-megapixel selfie camera, I expected a little more from this phone, but the unoptimized software eventually ruins the day. Similarly, in a bid to keep the price of the phone to the minimum, you also get ads on the phone. As a result, that's simply not enough to keep up with the competition. So maybe the company should now focus on the said aspects to turn things around in the future, which I am actually really excited about. So that was all for our full review of the Infinix 08. We are coming up with reviews of other Infinix phones as well. So stay tuned to Gadget Byte for more awesome content like this.